The Colorado River, one of the longest rivers in the US, is drying up. So much so that for the first time ever, the US government is expected to declare a water shortage in the region. But why is this happening? Well, to no one's surprise, scientists are attributing the mega drought to climate change. The Colorado River is famously known for passing through 7 states in the Southwest, having rich biodiversity, the Hoover Dam, and for providing drinking water to approximately 40 million people. But according to the US Drought Monitor map, the Southwest is exceptionally dry, which is the worst category possible, and it's taking a toll on the Colorado River system. It's projected that the river could lose anywhere between 14 to 31% of its flow by 2050, depending on how hot temperatures get. In fact, researchers say that for each additional 1.8 degrees Fahrenheit of warming, the river's average flow can drop by about 9%. However, what's being affected the most right now is Nevada's Lake Mead, which is the nation's largest reservoir. It's formed by the Hoover Dam right on the Colorado River. It's also a crucial water supply for Las Vegas, Phoenix, and Southern California, for both its people and agriculture. Lake Mead has dropped 130 feet since the year 2000, which is about the height of a 13-story building. The drought has also cut the dam's hydropower output by about 25%. This is what it looked like in 2000 when the water would come right up to the top of Hoover Dam. And this is what it looks like now, at just 37% capacity. Unfortunately, if it continues to drop, the dam might stop producing electricity altogether. Scientists have pinpointed that the melting of the reflective snow is what's making the river super sensitive to increasingly warming temperatures. You see, the snow is meant to serve as a protective shield against sunlight. But because the world is getting hotter, precipitation is falling more as rain instead of snow in certain areas. The snow is also melting earlier and faster in the year. So without snow, the water absorbs the sun rays and evaporates. So what's the solution? At this point, adapting. Water managers and policymakers, along with area residents and farmers, will have to adapt to new guidelines of water usage as the increase of severe water shortages is expected. Basically, people are going to have to learn how to live with less water. As I mentioned earlier, for the first time in history, the federal government is expected to declare a water shortage on the lower Colorado River, which will impact water supply for Nevada and Arizona residents and farmers starting in 2022. The 7 states surrounding the river have also created the Colorado River Drought Contingency Plan, DCP for short, with the goal to reduce water supply risks and find proper ways to distribute water within streams and lakes. As for what you can do, well, try to conserve as much water as possible. The average American family uses more than 300 gallons of water a day, and a lot of that water is wasted through leaks, inefficient appliances, water faucets that are left running, etc. So the next time you leave the faucet or shower running, just remember, we're running out of water.